Look at this boring, plain, and stale Minecraft server. Now look at this server. Animated, colorful, and packed with useful info. This is what a professional server looks like, and I'm going to show you how to set it up using only the tab plugin. Alright, before the magic happens, we need to get the essential plugins. First, make sure you're running Paper or Spigot. With that ready, you'll need 6 plugins. The star of the show is Tab, which lets us control everything. Then Placeholder API, which lets Tab show dynamic information. For ranks and permissions, you need luck perms. And to make all the placeholders work correctly, we also need Vault, LPC, and Essentials X. LPC or luck perms chat helps format prefixes and suffixes in the game. All the download links are in the description. First, look at this professional header and footer. It's animated, it shows your server branding, player count, and even the server's TPS. This clean layout is what separates a good server from a great one, and we're setting up right now. This is how I skip hours of configuration. In the description, click the link to download my custom config files. Once you get to the drive folder, download the animations.yaml and config.yaml files. Now go into your server's plugins folder and open the tab folder inside. Drag the animations.yaml and config.yaml you just downloaded into this folder, and if it asks, choose to replace the existing files. Head into your game or console and type /tab reload. The new header and footer will appear instantly. To get all the information showing it correctly, we need to install the placeholder expansions. Run these commands one by one. /placeholder API eCloud download vault, /placeholder API eCloud download statistic, and /placeholder API eCloud download server. After they've all downloaded, run /placeholder API reload. Your tab is now fully powered. For more advanced configuration, check out the video linked in the top right. But we're not stopping there. Look at the right side of the screen. A clean, custom scoreboard that shows player-specific stats like their rank and bounce. It fits the theme perfectly and gives players the info they need at a glance. Ready to add it? Go to the scoreboard configuration link in the description. Now go into the tab folder in the drive. This will take you to a document called scoreboards.txt. Open it and copy all the text inside. Now go back to your server's plugin /tab folder and open the config.yaml file. Find the section that starts with scoreboards. Delete the default scoreboard configuration that's there, and paste in the text you copied from the document. Save the file, run /tab reload in game, and your new scoreboard will appear. If you see any missing information, just use the placeholder API eCloud download command to install any placeholders it needs. For deeper dive, I recommend the video linked in the top right. Before you continue, I would like to give a massive shout out to our sponsors. First, Nautical Hosting. If you're looking for superior service for your server, look no further. They offer hosting in many locations, powerful hardware, all at affordable pricing. It's a fantastic choice for any server owner. I also want to tell you about MixupMPC. It's a server with a tight-knit community that's all about having fun on a unique server with active and fair administrators. If you're looking for a new network to call home, be sure to check them out. Alright, now for the next update. Check out this awesome boss bar at the top of the screen. It showcases important information, like your in-game bounce and the time, without cluttering the screen. It's a pro touch, and it's easy to add. In the description, you'll find the link to the boss bar configuration. Copy the text from that document. Next, open your config.yaml file and the plugins /tab folder one more time. Find the section that begins with bars. Highlight and delete all the default text under that section, and paste in the new configuration you copied. You know the drill. Save the file, type /tab reload, and install any missing placeholders with the placeholder API eCloud download command. For more ideas, check out the video Easy Way to Add Cool Stats Bar in Minecraft, which is linked in the top right. Last but not least, a subtle but powerful feature, the below name objective. See that little heart and health number right below my name tag? It gives you a clean, at-a-glance view of a player's health in the world. Let's set it up. This is our final trip to the config.yaml file in the plugins /tab folder. Open it up and search for below name objective. First, change enabled false to enabled true. Now let's look at the fields. The value is the raw statistic being tracked. Leave that as is. The title is what's being displayed after the value. Let's change this to show a heart icon. Set the title to and for heart symbol. Next is the fancy value. This is the formatted text that players will actually see. Change this to %f health, %health% to show the word health followed by the number. The fancy value default is a fallback for indices like NPCs where the statistic doesn't apply, and the disable condition lets you turn it off under certain circumstances, which we'll leave alone for now. Save the file, run tab reload, and you'll see player health under their names. For a full guide on this feature, check out the official tab wiki, link below. Before we wrap up, I want to quickly tell you what my channel is about. My mission is to create clear and concise plugin tutorials that provide free Minecraft configurations just like the ones you use today. If that's your vibe, hit the sub button, because there's a lot more to come. And that's it. In just a few minutes, you've completely transformed your server look with professional tablets, scoreboard, boss bar, and health indicators. Your server is officially looking pro. Thanks for watching. If this tutorial helped you out, a like and subscribe would be amazing. Check out the other videos on screen for more tutorials. See you in the next one.